So we did it for that, but also for the discussion of crosses on the flat, which I believe is one of the things you had wrote about. It wasn't as much for that reason, but rarely, you know, at an excellent level, rarely are you going to need crosses on the flat. You will need them more in novice and open than you're going to need in excellent. As you advance, you start to take your crosses on the flat and turn them more into crosses at a jump. A cross on the flat is not an efficient line for the dog. I mean, if you actually think about what we're doing, we're shaping it. We are not allowing that straight line from point A to point B in order to set the line better and to give the dog a particular approach to a jump. So as you get more efficient and more competitive, that's when you start doing more crosses at the obstacles, less crosses on the flat. Okay? Make sure with the rear cross on the flat that you're bringing up the outside arm at the exact